Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. My name is Munir Taib. I'm from Lansdowne. I recently just finished my studies in Cairo. I moved in with my parents, my wife and Roshana, my three children. Today, inshallah, I'll be cooking for you our Cape Town delicacy, that's snook, over the open fire. This is one of my specialities at my fisheries out in Strandfontein, Khamza's Fish Den. And people have been flocking all over Cape Town just to come and try one piece of this snook. And today, inshallah, I will be sharing it all with you. Okay, so to prepare our snook or to braai our snook, we will need some infused oil, methi masala. We will need our lemon and garlic dry spice, our tandoori sauce. Here we have a mixture of chicken tikka and tandoori braai as well. And in this bowl here, we have our 3-in-1 coriander mix. You can ask any spice shop for the coriander mix. They have their own brand that's going on there. It's very nice. Plus your lemon and garlic spices as well. We have our coriander. Or danya, as we would say, also means it was danya, not coriander. Crushed garlic and lemon, lemon herb spice. We have our tandoori barbecue, lemon and herb, garlic and chili, legendary apricot jam with snook, sweet chili sauce, lemon juice, some salad dressing, and our lemon and herb sauce. All this will make for the best braai snook that you will ever have in your life. And this is the cuts of the braai snook that we have. It's not too big. And from here, we'll have a relish that we'll prepare alongside with it. Now, relish is more not fancy for smoochie. Yeah, we say smoochie. The posh people say relish. Or say more no smoochie. Langsan yo braai the snook and so on. This will complement it. Such a mabai lekker gat because why? We don't have time to make a tomato smoochie and all that stuff. But it's maximum dope your fee. So it's nog lekker. Amalai. Flavors from a car hat and so on. So I wish they can call this smell-o-vision because you must smell what's going on here now already. And if it's still going to be prepared, ho, papi, that's it, auntie. Okay, so we're going to get started on the relish, or as we say, the smoochie that goes with the gebraaide snoek. So as you can see, we have no knives on the table. Ik loop met mes, ik werk hier met mes nie. Maar, omdat ik van die kaap is, ons loop met die mes op ons, elke dag. Right, so we cut our lemon, or our lime, with our knife. And as you can see, it's lekker scaped. So, you can have lekker slices on here. Right, so this goes in as a touch of freshness for the relish. Okay, so lemons are cut. Just gonna check the temperature of our pot on the fire. Yeah, so it must make sure it's nice and hot when you get it on here. Yeah, it's recht now. So, add your oil in now while it's nice and hot. So you pop it into here. Once your oil is nice and hot. And as you can hear, that's sizzling already. Yeah, so we're just going to give the onions time to settle in there. So like a smoor. Saute, that's the word, saute. But we say more smoor, man. Smoor, maaf. It says smoor. If it means saute, it says smoor, maaf. Sorry. My English is so quiet, my English is like up, man. Right, so we're going to give it time to smoor or saute on there quick. And then when it's nice and like soft and colored, and then we're going to add the following ingredients of the relish in there, or the smoochie. Say smoochie, yeah. No? Smoochie is bitter. Okay, so now onions are nice and almost softened. So now I take a bit of the spices by gooi. Some garlic and some crushed and some garlic chili flakes. It's also in there. So we'll take the tandoori and the lemon and herb, and then the garlic. We're gonna go over to the pot now to go and add in the spices. Okay, so now we're gonna add the rest of the ingredients of the green peppers. Okay, we don't add the flies. The flies is optional. You want flies, you can throw flies in, but I don't like to add flies immediately. Yet. But also must nobody buy, so it's coming in so nearly. So we add the green peppers and the red and the yellow. And then the lemons goes in there as well. So this is going to sit in the fire a little bit more so they can soften. And all the flavors can infuse very, very nicely. So just two more things that must be popped in there. Then we're going to leave it on its own. And then we're going to start preparing the snook. Okay, so we got our smoochie on the fire. It's busy simmering now. So we're going to start preparing for the marinade, the lemon and herb marinade for the other portion of the snook. It means it's sensitive magis, that I can die it. I like my snook, like a tandoori barbecue. So yeah, So what we're doing now is a basic lemon and herb rub, the spices that we mentioned earlier, the ingredients. This now goes into a bowl, all in here. Right, so we will add now our sweet chili sauce. Yeah, so it's going to give it a nice lemon and herby and sweet and sour taste to this. Right, sweet chili. And my opinion always is marinades and spices and recipes are basically guidelines. So if I do it this way and you prefer some other way that suits your palate, go for it by all means. I see you nog a trends met je. Ja, ik ken hem dus de Frans maken. Zo, maak maar zo jij het wel hier. Maar als het niet lekker is, is het niet meest koud. Jij hebt het avond gevangen hebben, is ik. Right? Some lemon juice goes in there. Also, salad dressing. Salad dressing is not only for salads. Right? So we're adding the salad dressing and some lemon and herb spices. Marinade. Right? So that goes in there as well. Right? So the apricot jam is there to balance out all the sourness and the acidity of the lemons, right? But like I say, also to taste. Even if you don't like it too sweet, no problem. The best tenderizer and the best marinade, you know, to bring all the flavor sam as Coke. Okay, so I'm catering also, right? I said Coke, so I cater for the mensen wat nou op diet ook so sugar free. Dus maar nog kwasa. Jy moet kyk wat jy eet, dis net pies en sambosas en jylle keel afgooi nie. So we throw the Coke in here to bring all this together. And then from there, you will see what this marinade does in your mouth. Right? Okay. Right? So our marinade is done. This is set. The other marinade is also set. So we can pop this onto our snoek. You can pop on the grill, spice it and prepare it. Onze kool is reg. Die smootje is ook amper reg. We gaan nou eat inshallah. Mag net waar jy aan. We gaan nou eat. Ja, ik heb amper mijn vingers gelik. Jo, dat is amper. Amper. Again, see? Coke adds life and flavor and everything else. Right. So, yeah, we're almost ready. Right? So, inshallah, ready to get the snoek on the grill now. So, we're going to spice it and put on. So, we're going to have two grits. Ik voel amper zoals Nando's. Spicy, lemon and herb. Right, so snoek, very delicate fish. If you buy your snoek, please make sure that if they cut it for you and they clean it for you, that this part of the snoek is not flaky. So just make very sure that this part here of the bone and this part here is nice and firm. So when you buy the snoek, kanala. Dis maak jy wat pap snoek in die poasa nie. Dis kala heel dag so in die poos, dan moet jy nog op pap snoekie toek. Ah, sê lekker nie. We're gonna start off first with our spicy one. Okay. And a lot of people wonder if you pop your snoek on the grill as is like this, is it not gonna stick to the grill because of the grit and that and the open fire and that. That is why we added the oil into the marinade so that the grit in the heat it doesn't stick to your fish. And it's very important also, I'll show you another trick that I also, ik kan niet alle tricks wijzen, ik ga het zo stuk wijzen. Ik kan alle tricks veel wijzen. Another trick that I do is, I don't close the grid once it's on the braai. I just flip it over and then I leave it open. And that's why we're gonna make the lemon and herb one. Okay, so this is the lemon and herb marinade on here. After I've spiced and speared the marinade on, I'm gonna show you a little trick that I do. It's four tricks. I'm just a magician. It's four tricks. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you what to keep the, not to keep them completely away, but just to not let to be so lastig by the fire by you all the time. I'm gonna just give that smoochie a little stir there quickly. Amper. I'm gonna flip this over on the other side. So, this is the lemon and herb one, and this is the peri-peri, tandoori one, maaf met peri-peri, tandoori. So, to prevent it from sticking to the grit, what we do is we put a piece of wood in here, like that, So now it dries, but it doesn't stick to there. So you can flip it around quite easily. Okay, so our smoothie is almost done, right? So, but because of all the flavors going on here, I'd like to make a sweet and sour type of smoothie that goes with the snook. So what I'm gonna add is a little bit of lemon juice and a little bit of apricot jam to that to balance it out nice and easy. So we're just gonna pop in some, like a tablespoon of lemon juice and then similar portion of apricot jam. Right, and there, put there a little bit more. So now we're just gonna paste it again. One's with the lemon and herb, and the other one with the spicy. Okay, so our smoothie is also almost done. So we're gonna get it off the fire, off the coals here, and put it set it aside into the bowl for the smoochie repo, smoochie bucket. Then, alles. And then, what we're gonna do now is something that I love eating with, that I learned when I was there in Cairo. It's the flatbread. Now, they don't have it here by us. So what I do is, I buy those rotis and I pop it on the fire. And then we're gonna have some of these flatbread. Now, many of the guys know this as we call, used to call it there as a ish or flatbread. They say you sell it by per pound. So this goes on here. Just it goes with the snook and the smoochie very, very nicely together. Okay? Right, so our fish is done. Final basting, it's coming off the fire. And we're ready to plate up. Okay, so we're gonna first start with our lemon and herb one. Final basting going on. Okay, so now we get over to the spicy tandoori one. The barbecue tandoori, not spicy tandoori. Okay, so our fish is done. We're taking it off. Our last of our flatbread is done. Die kom ook nou af, right? So we're gonna plate up now, inshallah. For final basting, you can just baste the back of your skin side, not too much. You want to keep that crispness also there at the back. So we just lightly curl it, spread a little bit of marinade on there. So when it comes to taking your fish off the grid, don't rush it. So easy with the egg lifter on there, the fish stays whole. The same with the side as well. See, the fish stays whole there. Righto, here we go. No rush at all. The same for the lemon and herb one. And as you can see, you can, once the marinade has been on your fish, you can open and close your grid as many times as you like. The fish won't stick to the grid. It won't break up. The egg lifter. That's English word for egg lifter, but I don't know. No, egg lifter. Allemaal kennen egg lifter. Right, that goes on there as well. As you can see, if you prep everything properly, your fish will come off the grid completely intact. Nothing will be broken. So our braaiing is done. So now we're going to plate up, inshallah. So what we do is take a piece of fish like that. See, and as you can see, because our prep was done, alles het gesort. So our fish goes in here, and as you can see, it looks so gevaarlijk. It looks like it looks so gevaarlijk. Right. So for this and all other awesome recipes, including the recipe of Hamza's fish den, amazing, awesome snoek braai, you can go to cookhalal.com and get our recipe on there, inshallah. And I want to thank and make shukr to all of you for joining me for like a list of maken in Poasa. And I hope you try this because jylle gaan nie spyt wees nie. Right? There we go. So as garnish, you can put on here some tanya. Can you say coriander? Tanya. Because every store you got for a can I get a posse coriander? Titi, what will you eat? Titi, say tanya. Understand? So we put a little of the tanya on here as a garnish, as a dressing. You don't have to, you don't want to, but yeah. So there you have it, braaid snoek. There you have it, gebraaide snoek. As how we do it at Hamza's Fish Den in Strandfontein. every Friday and Saturday. Shukran to all of you. Ramadan Kareem. And thank you for joining us. For all this and more awesome recipes, go to cookhalal.com and have a blessed Ramadan, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.